Good evening, Chairman, ladies and gentlemen. I'm extremely glad to be able to present to you today, and many thanks for the invitation by UGC. My recent project awarded by UGC is on automatic football commentary system. I myself, Wan-chi SIU, is with the School of Computer and Information Science. My field of research is on signal processing, information processing, imaging, machine learning, deep learning. And I have two partners. One is Professor Chen Xinwei, who is from School of Humanities and Language, whose expertise is on language processing, translation, machine translation. Another of my partner is Professor Anthony Chen, who is also in the field of computer and information science. His expertise is on 5G, wireless, industrial application. He has been working in AT&T lab and Huawei for quite some years. Now, why did I talk about the background of these few members? The major reason is that from this member and from their expertise, it is self-explanatory that we have the expertise in our proposed area on football commentary system, because we need pattern recognition, we need imaging, and we also need language person. And the project involves both practical and theoretical investigation. And therefore, we also need people with expertise in industrial applications and so on. Now, it's relatively difficult to talk after two excellent speakers. And therefore, I just concentrate a few points, which might overlap slightly with the previous speaker, but I hope I will try my best to give examples and substantiate what they said before. Now, I would like to present three key issues and also three other points to be avoided. And the three issues include, the first one is novelty. And I think the most important, as our previous speaker said, is on novelty. Novelty refers to new theory or new applications. And I must say, it is important. You must bring this out. The second point in a proposal to get good attention is that we should have breaking statements. Where should be the breaking statements? That should be in the abstract or even in the first paragraph of a proposal. Otherwise, the reviewer or the panel member would not be interested in reading your proposal. And therefore, to me, breaking statements or sentences are important for a proposal to keep readers to read on your proposal. Another point, perhaps some of us may easily to forget, is some preliminary results. And it is good to put some preliminary results in order to substantiate your claim. And I think that is a very important point. Now, I also propose three points to be avoided, right? And to avoid old or too traditional topics. If you are talking about something is too traditional and the reviewer won't give you high ranking, or they just reading the first few pages and then they actually may not read on your proposal but give lower ranking. And in that case, some of us may say, and I dig out certain novel and new words or contemporary type of study, say, for example, deep learning and so on. But even a modern topic, which is very attractive, but it may ruin your proposal. Why? If you do not know that topic too well as reflected from the proposal. I think that is very important. And therefore, of course, the best way to do so is to learn the subject you consider to be modern by yourself, and then get some initial achievement and then put it in your proposal. But I think that is important. The third point I would like to stress is that to avoid too wide a coverage. Why? If I cover more and then I hit more target and the reviewer may be interested one or two the target and then I get success. No, I don't think that is the strategy. The strategy is to concentrate exactly what you want to investigate. If you propose too wide a topic and too many objectives, you open up with more chances to be attacked by the reviewer. And sometimes, I must say, right, this kind of exercise, right, will be a kind of a fault-finding exercise. Don't leave too many faults, too many things for people to attack your proposal. I think that is important. And at the end of your proposal, writing your proposal, you should check your proposal carefully. Say, for example, I have usually 8 items to be checked by myself. Say, for example, I would say, what is the problem? Why is it a problem? Right? And why does the problem be important? And in terms of both expert terms and layman terms, what are the solutions given by other researchers? And what is the novelty? And would my claim of the novelty be convincing enough? Is there any initial results or facts to support my approach or my claim? And but also, if you put initial results, don't put a full paper into it, or otherwise the project has been done, and there is no meaning to give you any award. How does it compare with standard approach, most recent approach, and the closest approach? Did I do the citation sufficiently enough? Can the project attract much or good attention? I think these are the points should pay particular attention after our writing up of the proposal. Now, I use some terms, some words that I put on my proposal. Of course, I call just 2 proposals, which luckily has been successful. One is on supervised solution. And you may propose to make a thorough study. And make a thorough study, right? And tell the audience, right, that there is no study of using random forest and using these kind of techniques. And also so that our initial study has shown something. That something must be substantiated. What is the substantiation? It's the initial implementation. It shows that 5 or more times faster. Oh, exciting. It's useful. And you must claim that the approach is novel. And also, this is timely to study the subject. And also, then further elaborate in the body of your proposal and saying that this is the reason why resolution can be done very fast, right? And we also said that, note that using random tree for supervised resolution is novel, which open up a new direction of research for us and others to follow. And in the body of proposal, and you may elaborate some brand new idea and so on. And this is the strategy we can play, right? Of course, you must tell facts and truth, right? Right? And useful thing. And in my second example, second extract is on, football commentary system. Now, this topic is not completely new, and people did that before, but they did not do it in Cantonese. Now, saying just did not do it in Cantonese is definitely not sufficient. But did you say that? It is a very, we make use of the very modern technology on machine learning, deep learning, 5G technology. And this newer technology not yet be employed in the previous system. We check that, of course. And then we expect to achieve real-time performance. And that has not been much done or not been done, right? And what we say that this is timely. And then we keep on to talk about some of our technology, the and other people's technology, of course. We make use of faster RCNN with adaptive ROI. That is our recent proposal. And also the hierarchical back projection network. And also to tell people, we are interested in not only the implementation part, we are also interested in the internal structure of deep learning. And therefore, we study the deep back projection and avoiding unnecessary non-linearity mapping in the skip connection and add one by one identity layer and so on in the structure. And that is something our actually we believe making use of this kind of technology, it can make certain improvement of the previous version and models and so on. And for this big project, usually we have the interview. I actually hear some people try to treat it very casually, but I advise if we are selected to have the interview, let us see that as a chance for us to give further elaboration and to defend our proposal. And therefore, usually we treat it very seriously and to do some professional presentation as far as possible. And these days, it is good to make use of what we call the modern tools. And for the presentation and say, for example, effective imaging, video, or even virtual reality to do so. And furthermore, one thing is very important. Sometimes we do not need to elaborate, but during the presentation, do not do the one-man band, but to try to show your team effort. And we did that, right? And it is very important. Even in the proposal stage, you do not have the team effort. How can we believe you actually can do it, the project collaboratively together, right? And that is important. Now, we then call some of our examples. But our example should be convincing. Say super resolution. This is a small image, we enlarge it. And then people will say, oh, that image is already good enough. But you say, no. We can have much better picture like this one. The resolution is much higher. We can do it with deep learning approach and so on. And of course, we can show others. We can also show our previous success in other projects. Say, for example, we did do tracking with particle filter, which is a conventional method. But to tell people, we did that 10 years ago. It was successful. And people will believe that you have the black card to do this, right? And so on. And then say that, oh, now we can use deep learning. We can do it real time and much faster. And this is our strategy. And I must say, each proposal should have its chance of being awarded. And therefore, I encourage my colleagues and everybody, try your very best to submit proposal. But it depends on luck, let's say, whether you are lucky enough, right? Now, if you make a proposal with that quality, the blue rectangle is not that high, right? Proposal quality and the strength of that level. But if you are lucky enough, marginally, you get successful, right? It's nearly successful. As a PD, this time we won't be able to get it. But if your proposal is strong enough, right? And if you have the strength, the proposal is good. And if your luck, you still need certain luck to get success. Your luck of that amount, oh, cheerful. And I think that is my two cents of experience. Hopefully, it could be of some use to you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Siu. Now we'll have a short Q&A section on the presentation by Professor Siu for an IDS collaborative research grant project. Collaboration or team effort, as you mentioned, is an important element. As the project coordinator, have you encountered any difficulty in collaborating with your team members, and how do you overcome such problems?
Not yet. And since our project naturally get collaboration, we make our division of labor clearly. Say, for example, I'm doing work on deep learning, imaging, and pattern recognition, and so on. And then later on, I will pass my imaging result in terms of text production, which is in the what we call the primitive production. The primitive are the keywords that are required to produce sentences. And then I will submit that to my colleague. And then later on, we have another people and try to do the practical implementation. But the three of us will also try to investigate details of the theory of the individual parts. Therefore, if it is possible to select a topic that naturally can divide among members, such that each member can carry their duty individually and later on and to make the collaboration. I think that is our strategy. Therefore, up to now, we do not have the problem of collaboration among members. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Siu. And thanks again for sharing.